三个跳伞。First of all, I think I want to all of you. You're always welcoming, and I feel among my family here. And it's now after we already established the diocese. All of you now officially, and I really day and night remember all of you in my prayers, because it's a responsibility in front of God to make sure that you are all happy and on the right track, and you are always ready for God's plan for your life. And please remember me in your prayers. I'm the same person you met 2 months ago. Forget about the crown and the robe and everything. It's the same Seraphim, you know. But the responsibility, always the church, as we have the icons and the cross and the buildings and the clothes, we pass a message to the believers from everything we see, everything we smell. So about the serpent, while we are holding during the presence of the bishop or the archbishop, the patriarch, or the pope, we remember God's promise in the past as a prophecy and being fulfilled in the New Testament. I'll read verse from Book of Numbers. In Moses' books, then the Lord said to Moses, make a fiery serpent and set it on a pole, and it shall be that everyone who is bitten, when he looks at it, shall live. So Moses made a bronze serpent and put it on a pole. And so it was, if a serpent had bitten anyone, when he looked at the bronze serpent, he lives. And before the famous verse, you know, from John 3:16, it's a very famous reference, right? In 14, we say the verse, and in 16, the fulfillment of the prophecy. And as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, even so must the Son of Man be lifted up. The bishop wearing the icon, which is Saint Mary, carrying baby Jesus, to proclaim to the whole world and to reveal to the whole world the plan of salvation came through the incarnated God. And whenever I move, and you saw Mark or one of the deacons behind me with the serpent on the pole, to remember what God said, because it was a symbolic when the serpent spoke to Eve and deceived her. It's been bitten by the poison of this serpent, which is the way of death, or caused death. So God said, okay, I will allow you to remember that I will come one day and I will solve the problem. So he allowed Moses to carry a pole and the same serpent, but it's God's plan, because he will smash it under our feet. He said, look to this, but look up, not down. Because when you look up, you ask for help and mercy from above. Whoever will look to God's plan, even the world may pass poison to him, they receive healing. So the bishop carrying this mission on his shoulder, wherever he may go, wherever he may move, to pass the healing of our Lord through the incarnated God, through the salvation on the cross. So I'll tell you another point. Immediately after we consecrated the bread and the wine, and being converted to the body and the blood, I ask the deacon to put it aside. Because we look to Jesus. We do not need to ask the deacon to carry the serpent in front of the bishop. Because you found me didn't wear the crown in the while the consecrating the sacraments. I put it aside. And once, because the King of Kings on the altar, and once the sacrament through the Holy Spirit action on the altar, we put the serpent and the pole aside. Because I direct your attention and say, look toward the altar, look toward the east. So this is, as I said, when you come from the street and look to the church and find the cross, once you look to the cross upon the building, this is a church, it's a hospital, I receive healing inside. Who is inside? The icons, the altar, the fathers, the pole, the serpent, the cross, the crown. So remind you that you are son of the King of Kings. And the King promised you to follow the footsteps of the church to reach to the King. So it's all trying to use all our senses and our emotions to pass this test successfully and to gather all these pieces of information to live strong and clear, good Christian. I wish we did.
Say it now.
Yes.
Can I ask two questions?
Or if you want to add anything.
No. Is it, we can say it is a symbol for the cross or a symbol for life?
Yes, that's why I said.
Through Moses? Yeah.
Yes, yeah, that's why you find it. I'll read it again from John 3, 14, 15, and 16. 3:16 is the famous one. I will start from 14 to confirm Ashraf's point. And as Moses, when I said as, that means this was the prophecy and now being fulfilled. And as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, according to what we just read from Numbers, even so must the Son of Man be lifted up, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have eternal life. For God so loved the world, the famous one, that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him, whoever believes and look to the altar and find him, whoever believed in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. So it's the fulfillment of the prophecy and God's plan in the past being fulfilled in his incarnation when he appeared in flesh.
The pharmacist would be happy because the pharmacist, they put the serpent.
Yeah.
Because it's
this is about the poison.
It's
about the poison and the healing, yeah. He says we are grand healing here. All right. Thank yes.
You. She hoped it just for the diocese bishop. Because I've never seen
Oh bishop. Yes. Yes.
And the Pope too.
Yeah, of course the Archbishop. Yeah. The
Pope. Yeah. Not the bishop visit.
Just
the diocese.
Yes, for the diocese.
He cannot get his, if you have a visiting bishop, he cannot get his serpent while your grace is here, right?
Yes, and he's a bishop, we welcome him, we do everything to remind us with the same spiritual meanings, but if I'm here, I will welcome him, because we have the same goal.
But he cannot hold his stick, right?
Yes.
Thank you so much, Seyda. This was very
And I'm still learning, by the way. let me tell you a fact. This is the first time to be a bishop, so. So I'm still learning.
Thank you, Your Grace. And we have a small token to remind us of this event. We have a little Christmas ornament, Christmas tree, with angels on it, like Your Grace, Seraphim. Oh, so
not remind us.
And also, everyone is welcome for the Agape meal after.
Thank you very much. I'm happy. Please remember me in your prayers. You are very dear to me. This church is very special. God bless your life. And whenever I come, I find that among my family, and I feel welcomed and happy. God bless you. And then if you all, of course, if you need anything from me, my number is with Abuna if you don't have it, and together we can help you make sure that everyone is okay. And thank for the deacons today. They were great, and thank for Ashraf and Ashraf. Ashrafs.